time for the Dockers, 22 points in arrears.
Jetta's also starting up on the wing, leaves spur loose behind the footy at the moment.
Franklin pushed up.
Final turn.
Side of the square also.
Sydney by 22 points. If Fremantle got one big last effort, or a Sydney into a preliminary final for the third year in a row. Fife, as he started the game, on hands and knees. Parker backwards to Jetta. Jetta's really lifted in the last term or so. The ball now forward. Cunningham sends it down towards the 50 and out.
Hasn't had a lot of the football, Cunningham, but he's done a terrific job on Fremantle's line breaker, Hill. Hill's the player for Freo. They need to get the ball in his hands, driving it forward inside 50.
Parker up to 28 disposals. He's been just outstanding. Samazungu from Sanderlands. A bouncing ball towards Pavlich. Favoured by it, Richards. Well done, Tavern. A hard attack on the footy. Crozier maybe taken high there by Grundy. No free. Smith not clean with the handball. Off the deck by Barlow. Rampy behind Ballantyne. Ballantyne did well. Paddled cleverly. Here's Walters. He beats one. Handball off. Sutcliffe now sends it back. Big start, Fremantle, final turn.
That's what they needed, the Fremantle Dockers, and it was just the quick entry. Walters was able to have it, almost a shot on goal. Release. Sutcliffe just there, a good snap. Great finish from Sutcliffe. Really strong running defender.
Important sign there for Fremantle, both Ballantyne and Walters getting involved in that goal there. Rampy and Smith, the two opposing Swans for those two players.
Straight back, boys.
Really important here that both Ballantyne and Walters getting involved there. Terrific work from Ballantyne initially to farm the ball out to Walters. Walters, bit of fancy footwork onto Sutcliffe. Great start for the Dockers.
The one they needed. He kicked a really important goal last week. He kicks the fourth of his season. Just then, back to a manageable 16 points.
It's important to note Walters has had nine goal assists since he's come back from injury.
Fife continues to battle out the back, sees the ball punch forward, and then Rampy watches on and gets involved. Terrific stuff. Richards through Smith, Kennedy. Now a big ball to be won. Walters to slap forward. Pavlich, can he just finish it off? The angle is acute. The angle is manageable. And Pav has four. Can you believe the start of the third? Pavlich had nothing to work with. And suddenly, with Walters getting creative, Pav gets his fourth.
It's just that little deft touch and just a knock forward into Pavlich's space. And what about the finish? Just a left foot snap. Quality finish from Matthew Pavlich.
Walters involved again there, Jude, with the knock on. Has he kicked a goal this afternoon, Walters? He's certainly been involved in a number. He's only had no goals.
Matthew Pavlich has played twice at the ANZ Stadium, 8 years apart. Four goals in both games, and there's time for more for Matthew Pavlich. Lloyd took a good mark, his first final towards Hanbury, got away from Fife, and now Buddy Franklin, a long way from home. It might not bother Buddy!
What a reply from Buddy Franklin.
Was it ever going to be any other result when he got the ball 70 out, swinging around on his left with a little bit of dew on the turf?
Just felt Ibbotson might have got a hand to it, but it just sailed over the top of his head. The perfect reply from Sydney Swans right there.
Five goals at ANZ Stadium for Buddy Franklin. Two goals each time. What a beauty.
Come straight back.
We started up on a wing, notionally anyway, at the centre clearances, so he can get the ball running back inside forward 50. And from 70, he's as good a show as anyone.
Well, Ross exasperated the first two goals to the Dockers, and then the reply from Franklin. Three goals in 3 minutes of playing time. Bird works it to Smith. To the outer side, Goods and Silvani. He's produced so many moments, Buddy Franklin, and that was another on the big stage. Huge reply, Goods. He doesn't mind the ninth month of the year either. Long ball, top of the square, big fly almost. Here's a chance for Pike. Left boot, another ball, and it bounces through.
I think we might have a review here.
I believe it's touched. I'll just look to check.
Touch on the line. Score review is... umpire's call is touched one behind. And please review.
From that angle there, it certainly looks touched.
You touched
off the kick.
Okay, we want to check also the touch off the kick as well, if we can.
It came from the big contest from Parker, though. He was up in the air, went for the mark. That was what brought it to ground. And then Pike, the unlikely
review
crummer.
Completed. Confirmed behind.
Touched.
It's also touched
clear.
Off the boot there, you see from Gary Dickinson. So.
Right out, you're away.
Desperate times, called for desperate measures.
Right out.
Well, the double touch, eh? And how important that was, because a goal there may have taken the wind out of Fremantle's sails. So, the Dockers again. The challenge remains theirs. Spur did well, but the handball not clean. Pike has been involved. Jetta, Buddy, we've seen it so many times!
Oh, no.
We have seen it again!
Oh, no.
It's like the Shawshank Redemption. You've seen it a million times. You know how it finishes, but you can't.
Oh, Baz, are you excited? You're excited. That is just, again, came round on the left foot. Just watch him lurking there, charging forward. Great handball over the top from Jetta, and he does that every other week.
It's just been an incredible start to this final term. There's only been 32 disposals in the whole quarter. There's four goals, one on the board.
Step back.
Shawshank Redemption, a good flick, Baz.
Is there anyone that doesn't watch it when it comes on TV?
Well, Buddy Franklin, from the Prince of Hawthorn to the Baron of Bondi, still so much football ahead of him and plenty in this match. But number 23 gets it out to 23. It's a game-high lead again after Sutcliffe and Pavlich got it back to just 10 points. What can they pull together here, the Dockers? Walters, Clark with the height, out the back, Pav. Needs another, needs his fifth. The little give, Neil, in this really damp spot of the ground. Hanbury, happy to see the boundary line.
Lockie Neil could have got a free kick in the back there from Hanbury. Just rode him into the ground.
Looked pretty close, I reckon, Jude.
The next one must be kicked by Fremantle.
Holding! You've clearly grabbed his jumper here.
It's a poor free kick from Mike Pike. He just obviously wants to nullify Sandland's influence around those contests, but you can't give away silly free kicks.
Well, he understands the importance of the kick.
It's hard to see much from that.
It pleases the locals.
I think that look says it all, doesn't it? He knows it's going to be very difficult from here.
Top 15, play on!
So McVeigh to Jetta, and again, you heard the call from the umpire, Parker, who got so high at the other end a few moments ago. The safe mark this time at the defensive end. Looked a little slow there, a bit proppy. The kick from Jetta. And a bit of distance on it. Spurs kick touched and over the line. Welshy, what have they got left, Fremantle?
Yeah, look, at the desperation of the Sydney Swans defenders in particular has been outstanding. You look at both Ballantyne and Walters, just the nine disposals for Walters. They haven't been able to get their hands on the ball. They're desperate around the gap. They're not out of it. The crowd's really getting behind the Freo One supporters that are here, but it's going to be hard.
Sanderlands, he got some distance on that. Hanbury close to the line. And over. So 22 points, boys, where it was at the last break. We saw Fremantle capable of kicking quick goals at the start of the term. Have they got one last gasp left?
I think if Sandilands can get those big, long hits out into space, they need to open it up a bit more.
Brilliant from Bird.
Nah, throw.
Not so brilliant from Bird. The smother was enormous. The disposal deemed illegal. The Dockers in the right part of the ground. Crozier on his left. McVeigh will want the boundary. A penny for Ross Lyon's thoughts right now. Pleading with the bench and his assistant coaches to produce something miraculous. Sandilands to Mundy. Can he finish? Here they come. Terrific from Sandy. And Mundy, the brilliant finish.
Well, it's exactly what we were talking about. The influence of Sandilands around those tough, tight positions. The flick over the back. And what a finish from Mundy. Just quality player on the left, on his opposite. But just a quality finish.
Almost greeted with silence around ANZ Stadium. Back to 16. Plenty of time on the clock. Ross's men won't go quietly.
Here's the tap. Just a big flick over the back from Sandilands. Mundy, quality finish just onto his opposite foot. 18 disposals today, but there's his first goal on the board.
A quarter of an hour of finals football remaining. Plenty of time for Fremantle. Cunningham, Lloyd. Bird stripped of it by Fife. That was well done. And now Hill does get loose. He didn't look. Grundy read it well. He peeled off. It needed to be a shallower kick, and Grundy read it well off the boot. Gets back. Stops Fremantle for the time being. So 16 points the margin. Fife up in front. Cunningham waiting down. And now Kennedy cruising past. From the wing, Fife did brilliantly to keep chasing. The ball just eluded Tippett. Sandilands getting back to do the work. Handball not clean for Jack. In the back from Duffield. No, the umpire says he turned him. Good call from umpire Rosebery.
Just the kick wasn't to advantage of Kurt Tippett, and it just allowed Sandilands to intercept and come back. A good tack, strong tackle there, though.
How is Fife's work, bro?
He's just strong up and back, and also that... that aerial danger, he's just constantly able to launch it when he gets a chance.
Dawson has to sit and wait. If every Australian worked as hard as that Fife, we'd be the most productive country in the world. He is just unbelievable how much he does in 2 hours of football.
Every time he comes to the bench, he is absolutely spent. So, you know, he gives everything wise out there, gets his rest on the bench. Absolute professional.
What can they produce in the last quarter of an hour? Advantage. The Fremantle Dockers. Mundy kicked the last for them now. He's in the defensive 50. Tumbling ball. Neil, not quite. Walters went to ground. Rampy kept his feet. Got taken high. Fell to ground. Crowley into some space. And into touch.
But they're not going to be able to arm wrestle the way out of this Fremantle. If they keep it right in tight, that plays into the Swans' hand. They can match them at the contest. They've got to get the ball out in space. Looking at Hill again, maybe bringing Walters and Ballantyne up in and around. We see Ballantyne now at the stoppage here. They've just got to get the ball out in space, knock it clear.
So Tippett, that was interesting. Clark seemed to have him wrapped up. Fife tried to break away. Barlow's kick was touched. McGlynn close to the line. Fife again, the tackle. His work rate is enormous. Now Pike, he's got away from Dawson here. He gives it to Goods. Goods holding, waiting, and then sending a high ball back towards full forward. It bounces into the arms of Pike. 22 points.
It's got to be said he's looked pretty nimble in the forward 50. Well, Pike.
I think he came from rugby union and he was a nimble player.
He was a winger, wasn't he?
A winger. And that's where he's come into this role as a lumbering ruckman. But he just showed the speed then to get back inside. You could see Adam Goods waiting for the release. He wanted that overlap run. He just chose to kick. But then Pike hunted back to goal.
It was your classic rugby union play, really, yeah, wasn't it? The high ball charge, back.
Great one-on-one effort from Mike Pike. You can see him working back to goal. Goods wanted the overlap run. He just put it up there. But look at the pace from Pike. He was the winger in the rugby union, and now he's come into this position as a ruckman.
Well, it remains a big challenge for the Dockers, but still time is on their side. It's getting late in the afternoon and late in the game. Four goals gets them in front. 13 minutes of playing time. 9 for the afternoon to the Dockers. Ballantyne has been quiet. Walters has worked his way in the second half. Fife has been brilliant throughout. Now it's long ball. Pavlich, not quite sure. Main almost.
That was the option, though, for Fremantle. Just a long entry. It was one-on-one inside 50. They've just got to create those opportunities.
Step right. Hold there.
So who's the danger for Fremantle? Clark. He did well to get his hand on it. Back towards the line. Kennedy. He breaks one tackle and the second. Smith to Shaw. Gee, they did that really well. And then Parker. The little kick around the body. Duffield marks, though. So the kick, not good after some very clever work in close by Sydney. Ross Lyon, what's he thinking? 7 consecutive final series for the coach. 4 with St Kilda, 3 with Fremantle. Has never missed the finals with the Fremantle Dockers.
He's been fantastic today, Duffield. He's had 19 disposals. He's running at 100%. He's also taken the 8 marks.
Doesn't kick a lot of goals. 6-3 this season. And this to get it back to a 16-point margin again. To keep Fremantle in it. To keep them alive. Drifts across.
Push out. Push out. Blue dot. Yours.
Well, buddy. What an afternoon. Flashes of his brilliance at ANZ Stadium. Reed. Flew couldn't quite spur. Can he get the handball to Sutcliffe? Have a look at the red and white around the ball. They've got the numbers that, in the end, it's Spur who feeds it back. Fife, Mzungu, Ballantyne.
Hey, Stoke. Play on.
Well, Pav the target. The kick errant.
Got it ready. Oh, you take it. Hold it. Hold it. I've got it.
So Richard's happy to retreat. And right now, the Swans have got a foot in the preliminary final.
Grundy short to McVeigh. 18 disposals now for McVeigh. Here's Smith. 21 points to Sydney's lead. We've got just over 11 minutes remaining. We've said it a few times in this term. There is still time for Fremantle, but now they absolutely must get the next goal. Hanbury, good mark.
Sydney really happy to just take the sting out of the game, though. Just mopping up time here. Finding an uncontested, a loose now. Here's Kieran Jack. They'll work one down, try and get another loose, just taking minutes off the clock.
The Dockers have got to go man on man. They can't be able to just zone back. They've done it well so far for the game, but now they've got to roll the dice. Get a man and then attack.
Jack, the long ball down the line. It was fisted forward. Spur just got his handball away. Parker, what a game he's played. 31 disposals. Not that time holding the ball.
I think a bit the other way, Walshy. I mean, the man-on-man is a really solid defence to lock a game down. I'd like to see them take some risks both defensively and offensively if they can create a spare man up.
Rappel Hill's that way. The man to do it. He goes long and Walters!
Let him up!
Gee, that was a good grab. Heavy conditions. He plays on. He kicks a goal. It's still alive. 15 points.
Well, he's the man to spark them though, Tom, isn't he, Tom? Michael Walters, just quality overhead, just great grab, and then just knew he had the time to just turn around and kick the goal.
Yeah, they've got to force a turnover, don't they? They need to get the most attacking way, the most efficient way to generate attack when the opposition has the ball is to cause a turnover because the other opposition players are out of position and off they go. They did on that occasion. Walters so dangerous inside the forward 50. Turnover there. Deep ball in. And because of the turnover, Hanbury's caught out as a small defender.
He's so strong overhead, though, Walters.
Ross Lyon said during the week he didn't appreciate what he had, so he took it away from him. He's come back a remarkable player and a better person. Fife from the middle. What can they do here? The Dockers, main desperate. So too Mundy. Feeds it back to Pav. Just had his kick pulled in the end, whether it was him or whether it was infringed. The pressure was good from the Swans. Pike through the middle. A must-win ball for the Dockers. They do win it. Sutcliffe, long ball, top of the square. Who's at home? Well done, the Swans. The fist came, knocked it to the boundary line. Walters sees it over.
Yeah, Ross Lyon described him as a training animal.
Michael Walters?
Yeah, just a training animal. Top 5 preparers and trainers.
His return to the side from a foot injury has been nothing short of remarkable.
Sandilands to space. Neil knew where it was coming.
All clear.
Well, you just sense that there's another chapter or two to be written, another twist or turn. 9.5 minutes, 14
Chris,
points.
Yeah, plenty of life. Look at the inside 50s there.
Jude.
Fremantle, they need to take risks. They need to take risks with the way they set up defensively, and they need to take risks when they've got the ball in hand.
So Spur could have been held there. McGlynn gets the ball moving forward. It's a low one. It gains some very valuable territory. The cap claps from the dual Brownlow medalist. He liked it. The crowd liked it. Nearly 36,000, considering the conditions. A great crowd.
Yeah, especially with the rain overnight. It was probably just one of those... things you thought that might not even tip into 30,000, but they got the 35.
So Lockie Neal gets it and kicks quickly for the skipper. Pavlich had it locked away. Crozier to Barlow. They're still coming, Fremantle. They're not finished. Fife, brilliant to Hill. Bird got him. Handball back. They set it up again. Lockie Neal, a high ball. Crowley the target. The ball's on the deck, and Hanbury's handball for Jetta is good.
Well, the Swans' back six have been under siege in the last 5 minutes, but they've got the answers for the moment. Buddy, the Silvani tackle, brilliant stuff. Took him on, stuck the tackle, held him up.
Unbelievable tackle.
Three possessions for the afternoon, Silvani, and he's been brilliant.
He just hasn't given Buddy that much space, but when he has had that moment, he's been able to open him up.
Jack to Goods. Well, in the end, Sutcliffe was manhandled by Goods, and the pressure on Silvani. A chance for Adam Goods to make it really difficult. Buddy screaming for the ball inside. Ignored. Goods just might make the moment his own. Take on the responsibility.
Don't go forward of it. Steve.
So 16 years the journey's been. It suggests there's still a few more miles yet.
All clear.
Not able to produce the major he was searching for. 15 points the margin.
Wait for a bit. Wait for the call.
So Frio, they really need to take the game on now. It's back to 15 points. Still 8 minutes remaining.
Does.
And Spur to himself, and then the long ball. Tabana the target in that pack. Didn't get to him cleanly. Smith. McVeigh's bouncing ball. Franklin. Well, he absolutely loves it on a football field in that position. Couldn't get it into the hands.
Fremantle smashed the Swans in the clearances in this last term, and that's that dominance of Sandilands hitting to advantage. It's 14-6 in the clearances.
So we said a few moments ago they needed the next one, absolutely needed the next one. They got it, and they make it two in a row, Fremantle, and keep this absolutely thrilling contest alive.
Come on. Yeah, the Swans will be content just to bunker down. Get repeat stoppages.
Meter boys.
Put numbers around the footy. Frio get it out in space. Big wide hit from Sandy.
Less than 8 minutes to go now. Silvani got it from Neil. Mundy, Hill, Mzungu. Neil again. Well done in close quarters. Hard footy to win there. Parker, remarkable game that he's played. 31 disposals now, and Buddy, happy to see it over.
John Longmire's also sent Sam Reid behind the footy just to shore it up so there isn't then any transition goals from the Fremantle Dockers.
One side gets the rest, the home final, the other needs to butter up and go again next week. Sandilands, Mundy, well done, thought it through. Ballantyne, Smith, he's been with him all day, Smith.
Geez, he has played a hell of a game. If you're talking the best player on the field, you know, Parker, Fife and the like, but if you talk the most valuable player on the field, it'd be hard to go past Nick Smith. He's been enormous.
He's also had the 24 disposals.
Probably not so well known outside of Sydney's walls, but applauded within them, Nick Smith.
The Ballantyne goal is home, 6 disposals.
And of those 24 disposals, 23 of them effective.
Lloyd to tip it. Here comes Goods. Just draws the man, ends up all alone, works his way through traffic, back inside to tip it. He runs into trouble. Silvani gets a hand onto it, and the Dockers come away again. Momentarily, Rowan read it well, around the corner. Here comes Bud.
They defend the... the turnover so well, the Sydney Swans. They turn the ball over instantly. Gary Rowan on his bike gets the spoil. Quick transfer of play back inside 50, uncontested mark.
Don't go forward.
He's got three goals, two for the afternoon, buddy. He's got 49 in his finals to date. He's offline. He has terrorised the Dockers at times this afternoon. 16 points, 5 minutes and change. Still in the manageable department for the Dockers, but everything's got to go right.
They've got to be clean and they've got to be quick, and that's a good start. Good mark by Tabana. Young man from Victoria, grew up near the ski fields of Hotham. Kick not good. And Lloyd, from finals first gamer to finals first gamer. His kick not ideal either. Buddy made it look good. Arrived late, just couldn't hang on. Now Spur, Hanbury with him. Spur runs back inside defensive 50. Lockie Neal, next one. Long towards the wing and Crowley up in front. Mundy did well. Crozier went to ground. Crozier tries to go off the ground and Shaw gathers. Sends it high. Franklin, he had three to beat. Spur got the big fist. Ibbotson, Neal, Jetter chasing. It's still alive for Sydney. Franklin comes to make sure. Jack, Jetter from on the boundary line. They're supposed to be impossible from there. And this time, that proves the case.
24 disposals for Lewis Jetter, the 16 kicks, 7 inside 50s. His second half in particular has been enormous.
They work it through the Dockers. Mundy, the spiral punt. Main and Pavlich. Pavlich out the back. Here's the runner in Tabana. Well done, Rowan. Ran at the football, ran into trouble. Tabana was away. The Swans again have the answers when they need it at halfback. So Rampy, what an important player he's become. Goods has been important for so long. Kieran Jack, he and Walters, the two lefties go at it. Jack keeps his feet and goes again with the tackle, Jack.
Now they can just lock it down in their forward 50. Stoppage after stoppage inside 50. 4 minutes left.
It's three goals, Jude. It feels closer than that. Only 4 minutes remaining. Sydney, they've been the better team for the majority. Fremantle giving it one more go. Mazunga, who's had a mighty game. Crowley ran onto the fist cleverly from Neal, and Neal goes again. Now Lockie Neal can go long. He's got a runner inside. Crozier the sub, the fresh legs, not sure where to go. He comes back to Ballantyne, who sets it up high. Reed the spare man, and Reed the spare man marks.
That's why Crozier didn't want to go inside 50. He could see Reed sitting back in there, gave it to Ballantyne, and he just did not look. Just kicked it in. Reed takes the mark.
The driving ball, minutes away from a home preliminary final. Sydney, if they can hold on, the Dockers still desperate. Ibbotson wanted Walters, the tackler was Lloyd, spilled out the back, a chance still for the Dockers. This is a must grab ball. Pavlich there, had it on the end of his fingers. He'll get the second opportunity. Hill, he's got the speed, but he'll want his left, works his way back. Here's a chance. Crozier, not quite. And again it's Shaw. Again the Swans from halfback. They amble out and again they find a way to repel.
Long the ball comes. Thumping kick down towards Tippett almost. He gets the ball on the deck. Runs into Silvani. Bounces off. Here's Buddy. Still alive. Back to Tippett. They won't die, the Sydney Swans. Brilliant tackle on the ball, Parker. 32 disposals, all of them telling. Sand lands to Mundy. Pike around the body, bouncing ball through the arms of Hanbury. Still alive. Fremantle into Spurs' hands, clearing kick. Mazungu.
He'll play on and does. It's go, go, go for the Dockers. Time their enemy. Mazungu just charges through the middle. Main has space. Clark and Fife both out. Clark called by Fife. Fife takes it on. Again, the little bit of defensive work from the Swans, making it so hard this time, Reed.
Nick Smith was just battling with cramp, it looks like, in the left hamstring after a big contest with Crozier.
Play under 15, play on, play on.
Yeah, serious bout of cramp, but let's hope it is just cramp. The signs where it was.
Crowley up in front, almost, not quite. Well done, McGlynn. Use Jack, then handballed away. Maybe a free. Crozier on the deck. Good's right there with him. Here comes Shaw. Burst through the middle of the ground. ANZ Stadium is alight. One more and it's all over. Buddy in position A. Back to Shaw. Can use Buddy again. He goes back to Shaw. The old one, two, and make it three.
Great use of the overlap there. Shaw back to Franklin. Back to Shaw. Just allowed that overlap run, and then the small forward and Hannabury had worked actually inboard, just doubles back and cuts back to the leader.
Yeah, the game opened up. Reece Shaw started that passage of play from half back and carried it all the way through. Really smart play there from Franklin, and you'd expect Hannabury to go back and slot this one through.
They're a mighty team, aren't they? Hannabury now for his 26th disposal, first goal of the afternoon. What a side they've been for so long. First a couple of years ago, fourth last year. They're going back to the prelim.
...26 disposals for Dan Hannabury, 13 of those contested. His first goal of the game, but he's been enormous, along with Luke Parker, who we've also mentioned. He's had 32 disposals. His highest was 26 in the Hawthorn game last year.
We said off the top of the program, Jude, that the Swans seemingly in better shape physically this time of the year than last year, and in part largely to players like Hannabury. They've had forced breaks throughout the season. McGlynn's another one who's been big, got some spell time into Kennedy. Buddy's had some time off also. Reece Shaw looking pretty ominous right now, the Swans,
especially with that week now off. It just gives them every opportunity to make a grand final.
Hannabury trying to add to his extraordinary CV with another deep September run. Lloyd to Goods to Cunningham. He's got lots of space in front of him. He can pull it back to Jeddah. He does the ladder and he'll mop up the clock.
It's a big game, Harry Cunningham, playing off the wing on Stephen Hill, and certainly curbed Hill's impact for Fremantle.
You can see it's been a directive, though, to lower the eyes this second half. Just their ability to go inside 50, lower the eyes, change the angles and hit a target. It's been critical in the result.
So it's a game-high lead before the kick. It matters little. The margin's 24. It's the Swans that win in a street fight. Cheer, cheer.